We want to find the antiderivative of square root x minus x squared over x to the fourth. The first thing that you should notice is that if you try to put this under the square root and then simplify, you will not go anywhere because you will still have a higher, way higher power in the x in the bottom than the top. Right? So x to the eighth square root that, it's not going to do much. Right? So there should be another way. So you need to look at the bottom x to the fourth and you need to tell yourself, how do I eliminate this? How do I get rid of this fraction, in other words? Right? So notice that if you make this a fraction somehow, if you make a substitution so that this thing is a fraction x to the fourth, then the denominator of that fraction will go to the top, right? So what you can do is you can set x equal to 1 over u. Okay? So set that. And then the dx, of course, will be negative 1 over u squared du. Okay? And then the top, square root of x minus x squared, is going to be what? It's going to be 1 over u minus 1 over u squared, right? Which you can combine into a single fraction. It will turn u minus 1 over u squared, right? All under the square root, of course. Which yields you what? Which yields you square root of u minus 1 over u, right? So now what are we missing here? We're just gonna write this, we're gonna separate this, of course, because this is just substitution. Right, so let's write it using the substitutions we have. So we're gonna have what? We're gonna have square root of u minus 1 over u divided by what? 1 over u to the fourth, right? 1 over u to the fourth, right? Because this thing is quadrupled. And then the dx was what? Negative 1 over u squared du. Right, so look what happens. This u to the fourth guy, he will go to the top, right? Because this is the new denominator of the denominator fraction, right? So u to the fourth will go up. So as a result, look what's going to happen. U to the fourth will divide by u squared, right? And u squared will multiply the u, so u to the third is on the bottom, u to the fourth will be on the top, right? So u to the fourth divided by u to the third by this product is going to be u, right? So as a result, and there's a negative sign. Negative integral u square root of u minus 1 du. You see? It's getting way simpler now. So now we need one more substitution. Obviously, you're going to use, since this is square rooted, you're going to use a substitution. U minus 1 is equal to t squared, right? Because you naturally, square root calls for t squared and not just the t, right? So u is going to be in terms of t squared plus 1. Du is going to be 2t dt. So now what are we going to have? We're going to rewrite this integral. So negative sign, u was t squared plus 1. This thing was what? Just t, right? Because square root of u minus 1 is square root of both sides, it's just t. And then du was 2t dt. 2t dt. So let's simplify. You're going to have negative sign. Let's put a 2 outside. So t to the third, right? So t to the third plus, and how many t's are we looking at now? Just 2 of them, right? Plus t squared. Actually 2 to the fourth. I said 2 to the third, t to the fourth. T to the fourth plus t squared dt, right? Because t squared, one more t and one more t. That's 2 more t's to the 2 already there, right? So now this is simple, right? So it's going to be the power rule here. So negative 2, 5, right? T to the fifth, right? And again, minus sign kept there for the second guy. minus 2/3 t to the third plus a constant. Let's put it back in terms of u and then in terms of x. Negative 2/5, what was t to the fifth? T squared was u minus 1. T was equal to the square root of this, right? If you put a 5 in there as a power, it's going to be square root of this, right? And then the power will be 5 over 2, right? Because the 2 at the bottom is the square root, the 5 is what's increasing, well, quintupled or something like that, right? Right, t to the fifth, right? So this is that, and then minus 2 to the third, and again, square root first, so that's going to be on the bottom, the 2 in the power, and then what? The third, right? That's what makes it bigger. So to the 3 over 2 power, and then plus a constant. And not, we're not done yet, right? Because we need to bring it back in terms of x, right? So negative 2/5, what was u minus 1? What was u? U was 1 over x, right? U was 1 over x, so we're going to have 1 over x minus 1 to the 5 over 2 minus 2/3 1 over x minus 1 to the 3 over 2 plus a constant. And keep in mind that you can still actually simplify this. So now, how can we simplify this result? Notice that we can put this as 1 minus x over x, because the LCD is x, right? And we can take the negative 2 out, because it's common in both numerators. It's negative 2, and then we're going to have what? 1 minus x. Let's actually use brackets. So 1 minus x receives 5 over 2 power, right? And now, you forgot the 5, right? So you have to write it in. 5 is not common to both. There's a 3 for the second one in the denominator, right? So 5, but the x, the LCD, receives, remember, receives the 5 over 2. So you have to write it down, right? Now, what sign are we going to have? We're going to have a plus and not a minus, because already the minus was taken out, right? So plus, right? 2 is not needed, right? And again, we're going to have 1 minus x, this time power 3 over 2. Divided by 3 is written, don't forget 3, and then the x is written as the LCD, receives this power, 3 over 2, closed, plus a constant. Right, so this is how you would simplify it. It definitely looks less messy than it was here, especially with the one fraction and then the number after that. But hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.